Hello, my friends. How are you guys doing today? Let me hope that you guys are doing fabulous. Today is day 26 of our videos. 100 days to an happier, prosperous life. An healthy, happy, and prosperous life. Today we're going to be talking about relationship. That is correct, relationship. Now look, whether it's relationship between your mom, your dad, your father, your brothers and your sister, there's one thing that is unique about relationship. That when there's a relationship, it breaks down barriers, it breaks down waters. You can go to that person at any given time because there is a relationship. Like, if there's a relationship with your mom, you can say, Mom, can you help me so-and-so? You can discuss also personal things with her because there is a relationship and a level of trust. If you have a relationship with your dad, it's going to also be something similar that you can say, Dad, can I have this? Your dad's going to extend it to you because there is a relationship. Your dad, your mom, sister, brothers can know sometimes when you're not doing well. Maybe you're in a bad mood, you're in a happy mood. This goes on and on because there is a relationship and they understand you. And you guys are able to communicate even without speaking sometimes because there is a relationship. And the same thing goes if you're in a regular relationship, be it a marital relationship or a non-marital relationship, that it also breaks down borders as well, where you can be yourself around the individual or a group of people because there is some form of relationship that has been established somehow. Real quick, we're going to be looking at a few different types of relationships and just discuss it just a little bit. So let's take a look real quick at what the dictionary says about relationship. It says, it is the way in which two or more concepts, objects, or people are connected or are the same state of being connected. So as we go through these relationships, there are going to be also a few sub-pointers. But the next thing I'm going to talk about real quick is when there is a good relationship, right? How to constitute that good relationship, right? And automate that good relationship work. From day one, I didn't make mention of this, that your foundation should always be built on God, yeah? So these traits I'm going to give are good things that you can pattern, are good things that you can value, are good things that you can pay attention to, and you can practice it into that particular everyday relationship so that it will strengthen it and so that it will be better. This is not just that relationship between spouses, but obviously a relationship that you need to cherish, a relationship that matters to you, that you want to improve on a regular basis. And so these are the traits of an healthy, this is what I'm calling it today, an healthy relationship. So these are the traits. So just before we get into the pointers of the different kind of relationship, these are the few steps to an healthy trait. Allow your partner or your other person to be themselves. Do not try to force you onto them. Let them be themselves. Appreciate each other's talents and enhance it. No jealousy. So, because you might be a good singer and I just play music, let's enhance it together. And jealousy does not come in on either side. Shield each other. Protect the good from exploitation. If you do not shield each other, then exploitation steps in. Always be open to hear the truth spoken in love. So you can want to say something to your partner, but you can also be respectful about it. You don't have to go about it in a way to say, well, I am taking charge here because of whatever reason. But you can respect that partner, be it on the male side or the female side, respect the partner. Now, talk about your weaknesses to each other, be it agape related or even Ilias. Appreciate some space also at times, knowing that sometimes your partner may need some space too clear to your head to think about a few different things here and there. So those are things that you want to do, and learn to celebrate each other as well on different aspect, and you will find out that things will begin to be strengthened on those different categories. So those are some traits of a good and solid relationship to work on. So let's take a few a reminder.
Subscribe. Click the bell to be notified when new videos are uploaded. Remember to like the videos.
Thank you. Please remember to subscribe and also hit that thumb up button. Okay, so the first kind of other relationships we're going to look at is called codependent. In this relationship, you and your partner cannot function without each other. You feel anxiety and depression when you're not around each other. That also can also be dangerous, especially if you have no intention of settling down on a long term. The independent, both people, you can say they're powerhouse couples, but the thing about it is that they never make sacrifices for the relationship. They're all about themselves individually. It's like they just exist in pretty much, but does nothing to work on the relationship. Dominating. At one point, unfortunately, you possibly may date someone, or you might be even involved into some form of relationship where rules are laid down that you are expected to carry out. So you can say this is also bossy, someone who is bossy, and you need to follow what they say. They may say, oh, you cannot have any male friends or any female friends on either side. They may say, oh, you must spend all Christmas with their family only, or Thanksgiving with their family only, and it's not up for discussion. They may say, oh, you cannot go out with your male friends or your female friends if they're not going to be there. So you find out that it becomes bossy, it's quite so tedious at times to deal with those kind of relationships, because it involves a lot of pressure, that comes in there where you feel like your voice has been taken away, and just to make the person feel better, you succumb to those demands. There's also the rebound. Possibly you are the other person being involved in that relationship. I've just broken up. And before you realize it, you are dating someone else just to hide those hurt, just to hide those pain. But there is no plan for the future. There is nothing long term. It's just for the ride, so to speak, just to hide those hurt. But eventually you're going to realize that you're going to have to deal with it head on. And that rebound person is not going to help you to get over those things also accordingly. There's also the kind of relationship where you may feel as though your friends are doing it. They're dating a rich guy, so I'm going to go out and try it as well. And before you realize it, it's not what you needed. It's not what you wanted, because it does not go deep further beyond just the facade of going out, feeling happy, seeming like you're happy, but you're not. So it's very, very shallow. There's another one called good on paper. So you're dating a guy that seems like the perfect husband, or the handsome guy. He seems like he's an husband material, marriage material, has a great job, fine clothing, nice house, nice car, but something is missing somewhere. You just cannot make that connection. Even when he treats it like a queen, treats you very well, but you know that the UMPH factor is missing, and you just can't find it. You guys may even have great conversations, but a certain inexplicable connection is just missing. And you know that if you should go down the path of marriage, of a long-term relationship, it is going to create a problem. Now, the last one we'll look at is long-term, long-distance relationship. You feel like every time you go out of town, it's going to be a vacation. Whoa. So why not? Let me just go for it. I feel like it's going to be peachy. It's going to be great. But sooner or later, you're going to realize that how much that long-distance relationship becomes so demanding and so stressful. And you miss out on things back home. Miss out on things with your family. Here, fear become expensive, or maybe gas is expensive. You perhaps become so tired of traveling over those long distance miles and roads, trying to see him or trying to see her accordingly. He doesn't want to move. You do not want to move. And the list goes on and on. And so you would realize that only a matter of time, either someone gives in or the relationship goes away. Totally. Because it requires so much to encourage and to keep a long distance relationship going. Above all things, remember that when you think about relationship, it's got to be one where you're free to be yourself. You're free to express yourself. You're free to extend love and to receive love. You are free to communicate and to speak accordingly. It is just as though like it is in America. Free speech, a lot of folks hate that because they want to dominate. And they want to be the boss. But there should be that freedom to speak, open communication. Those are some good things to have when it comes to relationship. Let me hope that these few pointers have done something for you. You will think about them and that you will try to cultivate a good relationship among each other, with your friends, with those that values more to you, especially those that live with you. And you can begin to foster that closer relationship and work on it in every possible way you can, so that it will also help you to live an healthier, happy, and prosperous life. You take care, and God bless.
Never would have made it. Never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all, but now I see how you were there for me, and I can say, never would have made it, never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all, but now I see how you were there for me, and I can say I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over all you brought me through,